So early on this week, Fast and Furious Crossroad was released quite wordlessly, and this made me come over with another Studio Buy. So let's begin. Studio Buy Fast and Furious Crossroad. Let's get going on. Fast and Furious Crossroad was supposed to be released on the end of May, but was later procrastinated to early this week, 7th July, due to current pandemic. The game is released for Windows, PS4 and Xbox One. So this is the first game in the series to introduce cinematic story, which was not a very good idea indeed. So it's been a week now and the sales of the game doesn't speak for itself. Even show having prevalent graphics, the game is what they're actually paying for. The story is completely new and not taken from any of their movies, but which would have been rather a better choice if seen. And the gameplay is really confined, making it a story heavy game, and you really don't have the freedom to drive your car freely, and to me it is a very massive downside. The game is really not that big and they're divided into missions, and they are really confined. As I said, you literally have to do everything word by word in order to complete, and that's very annoying. Camera angles change consistently throughout your drive, which is quite provoking at times. And mainly, you don't have any keyboard controls, and how bad is that? You have to buy a controller if you're a PC gamer? Cinematic cutscenes are praising, but not as good as it should be in a game like this. It would be better if they had added choices and selectable paths where will occasionally affect the story. It would have engaged us to have a more movie-like vibe indeed. If you're a guy who likes free drives, like the ones at NFS Heat, then this would be a silly choice to buy this game, because this game doesn't give you this chance neither in offline or online, and I actually don't recommend it to anyone. But if you're a diehard fan, then you might find a deal in it. But if you ask me for my opinion, then $60 doesn't worth it. And it will soon have a price cut as predicted, and it's not just me. There are a lot of people complaining about this game. So if you're pleased with the trailer, then you must think about it again. Comment me down below what you think about this game, and I have daily updates and a lot of videos like this, and the best way to watch them is of course the subscription. So please subscribe and like this video if you like it. So stay safe, keep gaming, and I will catch you in the next one.